Sprouting of ragi benefits health in more ways than one. Sprouting improves the protein content and amino acids in food that help with digestion. So in order to sprout ragi at home, you'll need to soak it. Soak overnight or for at least 5 to 6 hours or even longer. And make sure that you rinse the ragi or finger millet before you start the sprouting process. After the soaking time, you will need to strain the water, and you can use this water for plants. I always do the same. After that, you will need to cover it with a cotton cloth. After 6 hours of covering with a cloth, you will see that ragi has already started sprouting. It will look like it has broken apart into two. So, and if it is still soggy, you don't need to sprinkle any water. But if it looks dry, you will need to sprinkle little water, tap the basket. Tapping the basket is really important whenever you're sprouting millets or grains. Otherwise, they will catch fungus. So sprinkle little water and don't drown the millet in water. Sprinkle little water, tap the basket, shake the basket a little so that air circulates upside down, and then cover it for the next 6 to 8 hours. Repeat this process every 8 hours, and then stop once you feel that you are done with sprouting, that you don't want any further longer sprouts. The sprout or the threads will continue to grow as you continue to sprout ragi. So you can stop sprouting ragi here or go for longer sprouts. And if you want to go for longer sprouts, you will need to repeat the same process. Sprinkle a little water, tap it, tap the basket or shake the basket a little, and then cover it with a cotton cloth. Keep inside the room, don't keep in shade, in sun, sorry. And then once you are happy with the sprouts, ragi sprouts, you can dry them in sun. It took me 2 days to sprout ragi under the sun. So it may take you longer depending on the amount of sunlight that you are getting these days. It's winter time. But in Orissa, it looks like the summers have come. So this took me 2 days. You can dry these under the fan as well. I don't know how long, they may take 3 to 4 days. Or you can do this in kadai on a low flame, or even in your microwave or air fryer. After the dried sprouts have dried, you will need to grind them to powder. You can use your processor or mixer grinder and give it timely breaks, and then sift the flour. Don't forget to sift it. And now I try to make ragi milk with 1 tablespoon of ragi powder or atta, homemade sprouted ragi powder and atta, and then I ran the processor and then mixed it with warm water and had it. This is your ragi milk. You can strain it and have it. Sprouted ragi is good for babies and elders alike. I hope you like this process of making your own ragi sprouts at home. I have already shared many other sprouts recipes. Do check them out. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If not, you can hit the dislike button.